For additional material, please see the PDF that accompanies this program.
Chapo.
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 Chapo, we wrote a book. We made it good somehow. We wrote it just for you. So shut up and listen now.
Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Chapo Guide to Revolution, a manifesto against logic, facts, and reason. By Chapo Trap House, Felix Biederman, Matt Christman, Brandon James, Will Menaker, and Virgil, Texas. Read by the authors.
This book is dedicated to the brave Mujahideen fighters of Afghanistan.
Introduction. Borrow this book. For 2 years now, you've been asking, who is Chapo Trap House? This is Chapo Trap House speaking. We are Chapo, a podcast that loves life, coffee, doggos, bourbon, and intelligent debate. We are the podcast that does not sacrifice our love for those things or our values. We are the ironic pieces of shit who have deprived you of victims and thus destroyed your world with your own logic. If you wish to know why you're perishing, you who dread knowledge, we are the gang who will now tell you. If you're reading these words, you're likely living in despair and hopelessness. You're fed a steady diet of thin, flavorless gruel by your leaders, your parents, fake friends who love drama, the fascist mods on Arrowid, and the Celebrity Toes subreddit, the lying sheeple news media, and most especially, all previous works of political satire and comedy. You find yourself in the dumbest of all possible worlds. Clowns to the left of you, Rathuglicans to the right, and the president? How about no? Like a veal calf, you sit in your crate, every day growing sadder, softer, and more delicious, thinking, there's got to be a better way. Friend, we're here to tell you that there is a better way. The Chapo way. This is the beginning of a journey you will never forget. In this book, we'll survey the blasted landscape of contemporary American politics and culture through our scientific ideology of irony, half-baked Marxism, revolutionary discipline, NoFap November, and posting on the internet. You'll become an initiate in the Chapo mindset and take control of the neurons that govern your weak, fragile emotions. You will experience success, probably for the first time. You will learn to live your life on your terms. By buying this book and all its affiliated content, you'll improve your health and fitness, have stronger relationships, straighten your posture, purify your brain chemistry, and gain more focus. Your children and ex-wife will respect you. In addition to desiring to become a brain-clear alpha silverback gray wolf, you're probably also interested in politics and taking a sideways glance at the news through the lens of satire. Maybe you became politically aware one crisp, clear Tuesday morning in September when you got the day off from school. You noticed your GameStop clerk had tears in his eyes as he waived your late fee on Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six. Perhaps around the time America decided to invade Afghanistan and then Iraq, you had an inkling that living in the end of history wasn't going to be as utopian as promised. Maybe after John Kerry reported for duty at the 2004 Democratic Convention, you felt a brief twinge of patriotic embarrassment, followed by a bone-deep sense that things will never get better. Or maybe it was when you graduated from college with six figures of debt around the time the economy shit its insides out. It's possible you briefly lost that feeling of impending doom in 2008 after the likable, cool presidential candidate defeated the old man who slept through all his flight school classes. But that relief probably vanished in a wave of Wall Street bailouts and drone strikes and a brief Democratic congressional majority that didn't even bother to pass the card check bill or push for true universal health care. Perhaps once you got a job, you realized that the pay, or if you were really lucky, the benefits package, was vastly outweighed by what work took out of your soul, as you spent your days white-knuckling it from check to check, feeling like the same idiot failure you were before you had a job. In any case, the last presidential election probably left you completely lost, tossed about in the gaping maw of 21st century America. You're just another plastic bag adrift in the ocean, with no power, no future, and not even a symbolic say in politics. More bad news. Since 2016, the Democratic Party, the standard bearer of left-of-center policies like replacing unions with low-interest Uber loans and bringing charter school apps to Haiti, has stopped even pretending to fight for you. All this leaves a new power vacuum on the left, in which we have taken up residence. The mummies in the Democratic Party are busy trying to rebrand Clinton-esque bromides like entrepreneurship and education reform, while the average young working person is desperate for healthcare, free college, and a steady job that pays them in something other than Applebee's lunch combo coupons. Our case is simple. Capitalism, and the politics it spawns, is not working for anyone under 30 who is not a sociopath. It's not supposed to. The actual lived experience of the free market feels distinctly unfree. We'll tell you why, and offer a vision of a new world, one in which a person can post in the morning, game in the afternoon, and podcast after dinner, without ever becoming a poster, gamer, or podcaster. Bernie Sanders' unexpected victories in the 2016 primaries and Jeremy Corbyn's Labour Party's near upset nearly a year later revealed the false choice between the Democrats' bloodless liberalism and the lizard-brained right wing. You don't have to side with either the pear-shaped vampires of the right or the craven lanyard-wearing wonks of the center-left. Dark days lie ahead, and many people are finally hungry for a fully ironic ideology for no good, entitled, downwardly mobile, politically hopeless millennials. More than anything, though, the current situation demands a huge expansion of what is considered realistic or possible. No, seriously, who are you? We are posters. We earn what we get in trade for what we post. We ask for nothing more or less than what we post. That is justice. What you call Chapo Trap House began as the brainchild of three chums who met on Twitter. In early 2016, Felix Biederman, Matt Christman, and Will Menaker sought a platform to discuss the upcoming election and also bring awareness to the disturbing presence of Dyson Airblades in most public restrooms. Did you know they actually spread 1,300 times more bacteria than simple paper towels? Soon after, Brendan James, Virgil Texas, and Amber Ali Frost came aboard. And despite the obvious lack of production value or the faintest tinge of professionalism, Chapo soon became a hit among dog fanciers, garnering profiles in prestigious old media outlets like The New York Gentleman, New York Place, Manhattan Times, The Knickerbocker, and Feet and Stream. Since then, our humble gabfest has become a Lovecraftian language virus, boring tunnels through the brains of all who encounter us. The important thing to remember is that, no matter who we are or where we came from, we invented leftism in America and are the only real socialists. If you encounter someone claiming otherwise, they're a Hitlerian NATO stalking horse running dog. Please record their name, address, and any other relevant details, and send it care of Chapo Emergency Commission for Combating Counter-Revolution and Sabotage, P.O. Box 42069, Penn Station, New York, New York, 10001. In order to guard against those kinds of revisionists, it's important to inculcate you, the reader, with the correct manifesto mindset. After you cut ties with your family and all your aforementioned fake friends, you'll be prepared to properly imbibe the lessons we're about to teach you. Go do that. Now, you may be asking yourself, Chapo, once you seize power, what will the country look like? Will all my favorite stories still be on television? Yes. However, you may notice a few changes when you're living in year zero of our utopia. The political program exists as follows. 1. 3-day work week, 4-hour work day. 2. Healthcare, childcare, education, housing, and food are free and paid for by turning all existing billionaires into thousandaires and or Soylent. 3. The use of logic, facts, and reason is outlawed. 4. Feelings become fiat currency. 5. The police are replaced by robot cops of some kind. 6. Everyone gets a dog. 7. All drugs are legalized and also become safe, healthy, and non-addictive. 8. Every single person involved in creating, promoting, and planning the Iraq War is pushed into a volcano. 9. Control of all media, newspapers, journalism, etc., is turned over to a mysterious Big Brother-style figure known only as the Beer Nerd. 10. Official state religion.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.